Welcome to Gifted Friday. I'm Beth Jeffers, joined here at the Fitness Factor in Columbus with Whitney Brown.
Good morning.
And today we want to continue on. Mm-hmm. We've talked about goal setting. We've talked about choosing a gym, some ideas on some weight management. And today we want to just go over some frequently asked questions that people have before they begin the exercise program or even joining a gym.
Right. One of the questions that we get a lot is, I don't really know where to start. So you've joined a gym, you took our suggestions from last week on how to choose one, you found the right one, but what do you do now? What's the plan? And that's a great question. And I think what I always tell people to do is just to start simple, okay? There's a lot of places that have Group X programs that can help you, which is a large group setting with an instructor, a certified instructor. They're going to take you through different things, whether it be strength training or some kind of cardio work. That will help you kind of get a baseline. Maybe you hire a trainer for a few sessions, but the most important thing is to keep it simple. A lot of times people go online and find these really complex strength training breakdowns, and I'm thinking that's a lot to handle.
Right.
Something simple that's going to get you a solid foundation of fitness is going to be priority one.
And I think, you know, there's some questions that are super simple, but I think a lot of you out there have these questions. And one is like, what do I wear when I go to a gym? Mm-hmm. You know, am I going to feel weird and intimidated if I have on sweats and a big old t-shirt?
Mm-hmm.
No, you won't. So obviously, you know, I think people have a kind of a stereotype that everybody in the gym's in shape.
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what? They're not. They're just people like you and me. They're just regular people.
Absolutely.
And so please don't feel intimidated. You know, that's why it's great, like we talked about, to go into the gym first and kind of check things out.
Mm-hmm.
I think that'll make you feel more comfortable. Or like you said, Whitney, go online and check out some pictures.
Right, absolutely. A lot of times people don't know how to use the equipment, and they don't not want to ask. And that's okay. And there's always instructions on the equipment, too. So feel free to check that out or ask the employees. Again, as you've shopped your gyms, you know whether the employees are knowledgeable, if they're certified. And I hope that you found a gym that has that type of staffing. If so, ask them what to do. Find a trainer. They're going to have a t-shirt on. They're going to have a gym shirt on that's going to tell you that they work there. Ask them what to do. And they'll be happy to show you what to do. And a lot of times gyms will have either seminars or they'll have sessions for new members that they can kind of show them where things are in the facility and how and when to use them.
Right. I mean, we want you to try working out at this in 2020. And, you know, I think you're going to feel better if you do. And so, you know, take some of these steps. Don't worry about how you appear and if you're not in shape. Come in and do a little bit at a time. And like Whitney said, choose a place that people are going to help you.
Absolutely.
Because that's really super important. And that's going to help you stick with your program.
And everybody was a beginner at some point. So everybody starts somewhere. I had a baby a year ago, and so I had to start over. And so it can be intimidating, but just get started. That's our best advice, is to just get started.
So as we close out again, we'll talk a little bit more next week on how you can keep going in 2020 and reach those goals that we talked about setting a few weeks ago. Have a good week.
For more Get Fit Fridays with the Fitness Factor, go to WCBI.com.